Hi, my name is Brian Rinaldi, and I'm with LaunchDarkly. And today I want to explore using LaunchDarkly within a JavaScript application. Now, when you think of JavaScript, obviously we have multiple versions that we can consider. On the server side, there's Node.js. And on the client side, we also have JavaScript, Node.js, React, and even if you're building native apps, there's React Native. We have SDKs for all of those. Today, we're going to explore the Node.js SDK, which you can find the documentation here on LaunchDarkly's doc site, as well as the front-end JavaScript SDK. So let's get started. I've created this super complex homepage here on the left. This page is designed to just show off both my amazing design skills, as well as how to use flags in a JavaScript project, both server-side and client-side. So right now the page just has some text, a button that is actually turned off, and a picture. Let's see how it works. I've got some flags here over on the right that I filtered by tag so that we can see just the flags that apply to this particular page. I'm gonna flip on the flags and you can see how it changes the page. First, I'm gonna flip this banner image. This image is changed server side, but I have it hot reloading to actually load in the new picture. Next, I'm gonna flip this show feature flag, which will actually turn on that button. Now that button says click me, and I can click the button and it will change the image. Let's take a look at how that works. Let's take a look at the server side code first. This is a basic Node Express app. The only thing I need to do to integrate with LaunchDarkly is to install the LaunchDarkly Node SDK, which you can install via NPM. Once I've installed it, I need to initialize a client. In order to do that, I need my LaunchDarkly SDK key, which I can find on the accounts page in my LaunchDarkly dashboard. I've put it in an environment variable and then initialized the client here. Once I've initialized the client, I can then start getting variations for different flag values. Let's take a look at some of the server-side code to get variations. As you can see here, I'm getting a variation for the banner image. I'm setting a variable named banner image, getting a variation for my banner image flag. I am passing an anonymous key because at this point, this application does not have any user data, but I can pass whatever user data I want here and then be able to target a flag to particular users with particular characteristics. This is a very powerful feature, but I'm not utilizing it in this particular simple application. Once the flag value is returned, I'm using the string response to get the correct image from the server. If we scroll down below, I'm also hot reloading, as I mentioned earlier. I'm looking for updates to the banner image flag, and if the banner image flag has been updated, I'm going to reload the server. Very simple, but very, very powerful. Next, we'll explore the client-side code for this application. First, I need to load the client-side JavaScript SDK. In this particular case, I'm loading it from a CDN. We recommend that you actually download the version that you need and keep it within your application files. But for the purposes of this demo, the CDN URL will work just fine. I am then going to have to initialize the client. In this case, I'm not initializing the client with my server-side SDK key. I'm initializing my client with my client ID because this is a client-side SDK. The client ID is also available within the account section of your LaunchDarkly dashboard. Once the client is initialized, I'm waiting on the ready event to then go ahead and start calling flag variations. I'm getting the flag variation for my show feature flag and setting this variable. I then update the page based on the value of the show feature flag. I also want to update it whenever that flag is changed. So if I were to change it after the client has already loaded the page, I want it to update anyway. So I go ahead and also watch for the change event. And if that flag has changed, I go ahead and update the page. This is how you saw when I changed the flag, the button enabled itself without having to reload the page. Hopefully this demonstration has illustrated how easy it is to implement LaunchDarkly within your JavaScript code, but also how powerful it is to be able to change both server-side and client-side code with just the flip of a flag.